Mike died.
And we have Croy Muzai.
Yeah.
Croy coming off a loss against
Zinger.
Zinger, yep. So Muzai is a Falcon. He's a melee player, yeah?
Yeah.
He plays Marth, Falcon, and melee. Falcon's pretty much the same here as he is in melee, so he's good.
Yeah.
I don't know much Croy's got with how much experience he has with the Falcon matchup, but
I'd imagine it's quite a bit.
Probably.
There's just a lot of Falcons.
I mean, the only one I know of is Jax, the PM.
He plays Netplay a lot, though.
Ah, that makes sense.
Granted, obviously Netplay is not the same as real life, but it's still a way to learn a matchup.
It's a lot better than nothing. And CPUs.
Falcon with a roundhouse kick to the head of the robot.
And that's gonna be
the
it.
Fear. The fear. Scared him right away from that one.
Although I don't think, even if you wouldn't have gone back, you would have gotten hit by the... from Robin. Starting something up, maybe? From Croy? Laser there.
Yeah, you're gonna get punished for that. Oh, wow, here. Almost doesn't really get much.
Yeah. And, nope.
He, like, sort of linked into a down smash, but not really. That's Croy's panic button, it seems, is down smash. Oh, yeah, nice combo. Air wobbling to knee.
Croy's gotta be really careful of stomp knee and just knee in general, because it can end his stock so quickly.
Especially Rob. It seems like he could struggle by it really easily.
Rob seems like he's light. I think he is light.
No, not necessarily. He's just kind of floaty. That's what makes that impression.
Yeah.
That was a good edge guard, though.
Gyro is going to be the main way he's probably going to end up ending stocks here, or at least early.
He dropped the top on that poor man's head.
Poor man shoved his knee in his face twice, so.
Yeah, that's true.
A muscular, electrified knee.
I thought he was a race car driver, not a fighter. What happened?
He's a bounty hunter. That's what.
Not Samus. We don't have any Samuses or Zero Suit Samuses in this bracket. The closest we have is Swablu, who plays Zero Suit as a secondary. I just realized that. But he's not in top 12.
Yup.
The gyro, yeah.
Yep. It seems like Croy gets most of his kills from things like edge guards or gimps rather than outright kill moves.
Yep. That was dumb.
As I say that.
Curse again.
Apparently.
Ow.
But from what I understand, Croy doesn't, or at least not Croy, just Rob in general doesn't have a lot of kill setups. Or, like a lot of his kill moves, like his smash attacks, are really slow and don't really. Like down smash doesn't seem to kill. F smash is kind of slow.
I feel like the longer this game goes on, the better Troy's movement gets, because he's started to move really well there.
Yeah, I think it's just, I don't know.
Spacing Falcon.
Something.
As I say that, though, he does get clipped by a jab.
Yeah. He's got to make sure that Muzai doesn't get in with a bunch of up airs like he has been.
Yeah,
that's the main way he's going to get combos. Oh, that's
so
good. Just a raw knee.
Jeez, he's going in. Oh, yeah. My. He went for another one. He tried to intercept Croy. He had the read, too, but Croy threw out an air to cover himself. Oh, so close. Oh, that was
that's gonna
super
be,
bad. Nope.
Maybe,
Croy DI's away and goes a little bit too far.
It's really kind of a tense part right here. They're both so high. They're such high percents, pretty much anything will kill.
This is sad. This is actually really tense.
Eh? Something? Something?
My heart, man.
He didn't
there.
Grab the gyro, so. Oh,
no,
cool.
What are you doing?
He went
no,
for the seven.
No, why?
Why?
Not like this.
You know, as bad of a decision as that may have been, I have to respect it. Because it's Falcon Punch.
No.
I respect it. It was a poor decision. Very poor.
It seems like once he realized it happened, he just kind of went with it. It almost worked, which is the sad thing.
It was probably a misinput.
Well, the reason it almost worked is because Croy was trying to go in and hit him with that nair, so.
Croy switching to Game & Watch. Okay.
There are some things I could say about this, but I don't want Croy to get your buzzer. I'll say it a little bit quieter. So, Croy can just kind of like position himself at ledge and then down tilt Falcon's recovery over and over, and it really sucks for Falcon. So, I don't know if he knows that.
So,
I feel like he probably does.
So,
He's gotta get him down in that position first before he can down tilt him though.
Actually, is it cool if I had you two play first? Before you get
through?
Is it
and
cool if I had
that's
you two play first?
That's a dead Game & Watch with a knee.
I just need to, like, get some food now. right. There's like loser sets like.
And
yeah,
going for us. He's doing very well. He's. I think Muzai's trying to go for an early kill with that with a down throw up airs to knee. Yep.
Yep.
That's exactly what we were talking about. If Kuroi can get Muzai into that position more, just as. Go out onto 16th. So go out the front entrance, take a right, go out to 16th main road there, take a left, go down past Cub Foods, and there's a bunch of flayed places.
Alright, be quick.
Be quick. Run, Forrest, run.
Stay hydrated.
As I say that, we have. Kuroi actually took the lead back, okay.
Speaking of food, we got food in this game. You can watch his bacon.
He's bacon, yeah.
Oh, no.
Oh.
He drops like a rock.
And
they both. Oh, the homie stock.
Homie stock. I saw Kuroi shaking his head, and I was like, well, Kuroi's not the one who has to eat, but.
I mean, you don't want to take those.
Yeah. I mean, maybe it's just me. Depending on the person I'm playing, I'll take it, but like.
I always take them, but.
I don't ever feel good about it.
No, no.
Because it's not.
You don't want to win on an SD. Oh.
Oh.
Oh my gosh, he just went out there. He just went out and did it.
That SD might have cost him. That homie stock might cost him a game. If he doesn't end this quick.
That's why I don't homie stock.
Why I try not to homie stock unless I'm doing very, very well against a person. 101. I mean, he took it with the Nair, but that's Game & Watch's Nair. It was kind of expected.
Yeah.
We get shield pressure with up air. And,
those for hammer that does not hit at all.
Yeah.
It was also only a 3. Ooh. Barely gets away from that knee.
I don't know the meta behind the hammer, so I can't really say too much about that.
Oh,
and that's
wow.
Gonna be a game for Kuroi. He's up 2-0 on Muzai. Muzai's going Luigi.
Oh
boy.
Out. Oh no.
Oh no. I have.
So, his Luigi's really gimmicky and dumb, but it's actually slightly good.
It's.
I don't think it will do better than his Falcon, though.
I have to agree. I played his Luigi earlier. I did really well against it, actually. I almost beat him.
Yeah.
That's me.
It's really gimmicky.
It's gimmicky, but it works. Once you figure it out, then it's not so much of a challenge.
It almost beat me once, partially because it's a bad magic for Sonic. At the same time, he never actually took a game from me with it, so. He didn't friendly stuff.
Yeah.
Combos
the
into
sausage.
A singular sausage.
I think
is
it was
sausage
two.
Or bacon?
I don't know what it is.
Both. It's both.
Screw it. Both.
Breakfast. It's breakfast.
It is food. So, Kuroi right now doesn't even have a single.
Yeah.
Yep, that's it's a nice 0 to death 30 there.
Waste of 9. So, okay. So, for the hammer, you can't get.
It's like some math.
You cannot get the last two numbers you just got. So, like, he got a 9 and a 2. Now he cannot get a 9 and or a 2 for his next one. And then I think there's a certain number of dots that show up above the hammer.
I think it's 1, 2. I think it's 1 and 2. Just 2, 1 and 2.
Yeah,
dots.
It's 1 and 2 dots. I think if it's 2, that means the next one could be a 9.
I don't really.
I don't know exactly. It's either one of them signifies that the next one could be a 9, and that makes like a 1 in 3 chance. I don't know the specifics.
There's apparently also a way to tell if you have a 9 or not, but again,
but
I don't know.
I've never heard that. He's like, not bucketing his fireball, but he should be.
He really should be, but there's just, like, it's math, apparently.
Sort of, yeah.
But a lot of people, like, I've faced a bunch of Game & Watches online who all, like, they all pretty much, every time they had a 9, they knew they had a 9 and saved it for the right moment.
Yeah. It's not complicated. You just have to go, like, look it up and memorize it.
Which I have not done.
Same.
He's like going for the upbeat kill, but it didn't seem like he was even going to have like the possibility of hitting the hitbox for it anyway.
I didn't want to say this, but he goes Luigi when he doesn't really care, it seems, so. I don't want to say that's what's happening, but it might be.
I think he still cares, but maybe he's just trying to get more experience with his Luigi. I don't know.
Maybe. I don't know. Oh man, chill. No. Oh, that's it.
That's
a 3-0.
That's actually kind of depressing. But whenever you get hit by that, the ice, I just
when you just fall to your death. Oh man,